友，欢迎您回到娱乐漫谈，我是周乐。介绍这个单元的嘉宾，他是坐在我旁边的 Johan Fox。 Hey Johan, welcome to my show.
Lily, thank you for having me here today. It's a pleasure to be on your show.
Johan, please tell us about your relationship with Master Life Financial and a briefly introduction of yourself.
Lily, thank you for having me here today. My name is Johan Fox and I'm a partner in Master Life Financial Group.I'm also a certified financial planner as well as an IRS enrolled agent, which is the highest credential the IRS awards.
Wonderful. So it's an honor to have you to talk to us about after Trump's tax reform, how will that impact the residents in the Bay Area and also in the entire California?万富理财他们将要在1月20号的下午举办一场在2018年非常重要的座谈会。那这场座谈会呢，希望大家踊跃的来报名参加。这个主题就是川普总统的税改以后对于加州还有湾区的居民的影响。
Today's topic is how the new tax reform will impact our viewers here in the Bay Area, especially high income families in Silicon Valley.
Okay, and when does this tax reform beingaffected? Does that start from right now?
Right. So the new tax reform will impact your 2018 tax return. So don't worry about your 2017 tax return that will be filed in 2018. Mm-hmm. That is not going to be affected. Also keep in mind, this is the biggest tax overhaul since the Reagan administration. So things are still being worked out at this point.
Really?
Yes.
Even that President Trump has already signed the final bill?
That's correct. There's some details that are still have to be cleared out at this point.
Oh, okay. And there are a lot of talks about reducing or minimizing the tax bracket for the individual people. How many tax bracket has been reduced?
So the new tax code actually kept 7 tax brackets.And the highest tax bracket is at 37%. Now it's been reduced to 37%. In general, the marriage penalty has been removed, which is great news, except for the highest tax bracket.
Okay.
Income earners, for single income earners over $500,000and married filing jointly over $600,000 fall now into the 37% bracket.
Okay. And the corporation tax is the most, the biggest beneficiary of it.
That is correct. Yes. We're going to address that, I think, in a future show.
In the future show. Today, we are pinpointing on the individual tax being affected by the Trump's tax reform.
Lily, that is correct. Okay. We're going to talk about individuals today.
Okay. Johan, and there are also a lot of talks about the tax advantages for the middle-class citizen has been removed or has been demolished. How many tax code has been minimized at this point, as far as you know?
Okay, Lily, you're correct. We were initially really worried about the removal of several of the key tax advantages that have been in the code for really a long time. The good news is that most of them actually are staying intact at this point.For example, the step-up in basis upon death of a spouse,
which
basically gives the homeowners with highly appreciated real estate forgiveness of the capital gains taxes, which usually would be due upon the sale, and that is still available. And that is really, really good, great news for Silicon Valley homeowners and the housing values in Silicon Valley.
Hmm.
And also Section 1031 exchanges. 1031 exchanges are still intact. That is really good news. Anyone with an investment property can still exchange the property without having to pay taxes upon, upon the sale of the property. And that is good news for the Bay Area because housing values would have been affected if 1031 exchanges would not be in place anymore.
So 1031 exchange has not been removed and it remained the same. Investors still can enjoy this tax defer until the last sale of the property.
That is correct for residences.
Yeah.
However, for personal property, 1031 exchanges have been removed from the code, but it rarely affects any taxpayers.
Okay, okay. That's what we want to know. And we also heard that, Johan, there are state-specific change in the certain tax code. Can you tell us and elaborate a little bit on that, which affect the California residents, especially in the Bay Area?
There were unlimited deduction of your state income taxes and your local property taxes, which also was commonly known as the SALT deduction. That has been removed. And this is a significant change facing Bay Area residents, and it will affect potentially property values in the Bay Area. The new code provides for a limit of a $10,000 deduction, and it's not indexed for inflation. To give you an idea, a single person earning about $135,000 will have an approximate California income tax liability of $10,000 already. So any Californian making more than $130,000 could not deduct those income taxes anymore. Hmm. And since the taxpayer already maxed out on his SALT deductions, she could not deduct her property taxes anymore either.
Wow. Okay. Johan, how about the married people? Are they still able to deduct the $20,000 from their income tax?
So unfortunately, this is an other marriage penalty in the tax code. Hmm. So the $10,000 applies to both single and married tax filers. Hmm. They both get the $10,000 deduction.
Hey, Johan, how about this SALT? This term, S-A-L-T, how would that have the potential impact on the Bay Area housing market and also the job market?
Lily, that is another really great question. Most people that already can afford to purchase real estate in the Bay Area already pay over $10,000 in state income taxes. That also means that this effectively eliminates the deductibility of all property taxes on personal residences. They will reduce the incentive for the purchase of real estate in the Bay Area. In regards to the job market, it will be more difficult for states with high income taxes to attract top talent.
Okay, understood. You know, 观众朋友，如果你想要知道更多的关于税改以后影响加州的居民，还有 Bay Area 的居民的话，就请大家来参加1月20号由万富理财所举办的这场 Tax Reform 如何影响我们的这场座谈会。And Johan, well, our program is reaching the end of it. We have probably 1 minute. Let's sum it up and give us a brief summary.
Lily, so the good news is that a lot of the provisions that we feared would be removed from the tax code are actually still available to the taxpayers. Now, for Bay Area residents, however, the deduction for property and income taxes with a limit of $10,000, of course, will have an impact on the local market. But otherwise, the tax code hasn't gone as far as we feared it would go.
Okay, wonderful. 好的，观众朋友，我们这个单元呢已经就结束了，但是希望大家能够踊跃的报名参加1月20号这场座谈会，因为 tax 也许您从你的税务师这边也听到了，但是如果是从万富理财这个地方讲出去的话，都是跟自己所有的全面财务规划有关的。希望大家踊跃报名参加。Thank you, Johan. Thank you,
Lily. Thank you for watching. We will see you at one of our upcoming seminars.
好的，观众朋友，我们这个单元结束，进一段广告，马上回来继续进行下面一段精彩的访谈。不要走开，马上回来。